सदाशिवसमानं अहं शंकराचार्य मध्यमस्मदाचार्य पर्यंता वंदे गुरुपरंपरा श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानामालयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतं वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्ते नमः। ॐ सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः। यो ब्रह्माणि धातुगुरो वेदाश्च प्रणोति तस्मै तगुंहदेवमात्मोद्यप्रकाशमोक्षुरोऽयि शरणमहं प्रपद्ये। ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः। आम्नाय अन्तिकं संसिद्धम् आदिमध्यान्तवर्जितम् आनन्दघनमापूर्णम् आत्मज्योतिरुपास्महे। Continuing with the same Adhikarana, the 8th Sutra says, is introduced by saying Apicha in continuation to what was said earlier as to the examples given, Purusha, Purushavat or Ashmavat. If you consider this as Purusha, meaning there is a dependency on Purusha, the way a blind person who is able to walk walks but cannot see with the help of another who cannot walk but can see, or like the Ashmavat, like a magnet which by its mere presence attracts the iron elements, so it doesn't move but the iron elements have pravritti. Similarly, let there be pravritti of pradhana, whereas Purusha is still. So this is the example given, which was refuted by saying as what, even in that case tathapi, even then what, there is still dependency, and with dependency, if you agree with the dependency, then your own Darshana is compromised, said the Vedanti to the Sankhya Paksha. Now the next sutra in continuation is Apicha, and moreover what? Angitva anupapattescha. So Angitva anupapattehe cha, two words are there. So Anga Angi Bhava, if at all there is an expectancy, then what will happen? Your gunas, expectancy between what now? Further, your sattva, rajas and tamas, which is the swarupa of pradhana. Pradhana is not made up of parts. Pradhana is one indivisible entity. Now this achetana pradhana, which is not made up of sattva, rajas, tamas as angas or parts, and pradhana is not angi, or sattva and rajas are not anga angi, they don't have dependency on each other, that kind of a pradhana where sattva, rajas, tamas is its very nature, there is no dependency among each other. So paraspara anapekshanam gunanam samyavastha, what guna? Sattva, rajas, tamas guna. So sattva, rajas, tamas is a guna, is expected, accepted as guna. Sattva is a guna, sattva guna. But then this guna and guni have angangi bhava. But that kind of a angangi bhava is not there here. So paraspara anapekshanam, who do not mutually expect each other or are not dependent on each other, those kind of independent sattva, rajas and tamas, which are actually put together called as pradhana, when there is a samyavastha. So paraspara anapekshanam gunanam samyavastha prachutya bhavena, this becomes a hetu now, because there is no dependency on each other. Sattva, rajas and tamas are independent gunas, and when they have samyavastha they are called as pradhana. when they fall out of balance, meaning samyavastha is balance. When they fall out of balance, then there is a srishti, we have seen in the last patha. Now this samyavastha prachyuti will not take place. Why? Because there is no dependency on each other. Why will they go out of imbalance? Only when something is out of your control or you depend on someone else, then there is a change. So there is no change possible if at all sattva, rajas, tamas, gunas themselves are not dependent on each other. Thereby samyavastha will remain samyavastha. Thereby what samyavastha prachyuti abhavena anga angitva. Angitva is anga angitva. Angitva anupapattehe. There is no possibility of angangi bhava. Therefore, pradhanam na jagat karanam. So, prachyutya, basically what, for something to be created, there have to be parts which have to come together. Now, this pradhana is not made up of parts. It is made up of three gunas, but they are not parts. They are not angas. Therefore, if you want to put together something in a different proportion, that is the imbalance between sattva, rajas and tamas, then what should happen? Sattva, rajas and tamas should, the way they are right now, they should get destroyed in that form. And then they should come together in another form. So whatever samyavastha is there, that samyavastha, nasha should take place. And then there should be utpatti of asamyavastha of these gunas. That kind of a thing is not possible. Therefore, what your guna and pradhana do not have anga angi sambandha. Therefore, what that becomes a hetu now. Angitva anupapatti means angitva of pradhana is not possible. Meaning, pradhana having parts is unacceptable, it is untenable due to anupapatti, untenability of angitva of being one with parts for pradhana. Therefore, what? Therefore, also, cha and therefore, also, apicha. Apicha is that meaning as to for this reason also, pradhana cannot be jagat karana because pradhana, which is sattva, rajas, tamas, has to become karya by reassembly, and that reassembly is possible in asamyavastha with whatever imbalance as per karma if you mean, even then the samyavastha has to be undergo nasha. That is not possible. Therefore angangi bhava is not possible, and therefore pradhana cannot be jagat karana. That is the sutra artha. Sankhyamate gunatraya samyavastha prakritihi. So prakriti or pradhana, what we call as moola prakriti or maya, is what? Samyavastha of three gunas. Sattva, rajas and tamas are in equal proportion. That time there is no srishti. Sa kutastha va vikarini va. Now the siddhanti asks, this samyavastha of prakriti, samyavastha leading to this prakriti or pradhana, is it kutastha or vikarini? Meaning what? Kutastha means kutavar tishtati iti kutastha. We saw in the last part, it does not change, it does not move. So that changeless, motionless presence is what is called as kutastha prakriti. Is it so? Or other option is what? Vikarini. Means what? There is vikara. Vikaraha asya santi iti, asyaha prakriti is strilinga. So asyaha prakriti he vikaraha santi iti vikarini prakriti. So is this changeless or is going to undergo changes? Prakriti, pradhana. These are the two options given by the siddhanti. Adye pakshe, if you say it is kutastha, if the sankhya purvapakshi says that it is kutastha, changeless prakriti or pradhana, then adye paraspara anapekshanam gunanam samyavastha aprachyutya bhavina. सॉरी साम्य अवस्था प्रच्युत्य भावीन अवस्था इज स्त्रीलिंग सो साम्य अवस्था प्रच्युति विल नॉट टेक प्लेस मीनिंग इम्बैलेंस वोंट टेक प्लेस अभावीन प्रकृति प्रच्युति अभावीन अंगांगित्व अनुपपत्ति सो दिस अंग अंगित अंगित्व भाव वोंट बी देर अंगांगी भाव वोंट बी देर सो अंगांगित्व अनुपपत्ति कार्य अनुदय प्रसंग देर विल बी नो पॉसिबिलिटी ऑफ कार्य कमिंग अप फ्रॉम समथिंग विच इज पार्टलेस ओनली वेन पार्ट्स आर देर दे कैन बी रीअसेंबल्ड एंड यू कैन गेट अ न्यू कॉन्फिग्रेशन सो कार्य कैन बी सेट टू बी न्यू कॉन्फिग्रेशन ऑफ सत्व एंड रजस सत्व रजस एंड तमस सो जगत इज अ कार्य इट इज रीअसेंबली ऑफ सत्व रजस एंड तमस वेन सत्व रजस तमस आर इन इक्वल प्रपोर्शन देन देर इज नो कार्य पॉसिबल सो दे हैव दिस काइंड ऑफ अ सिस्टम देर बाय कार्यस्य अनुदय जगत इज कार्य सो जगत वोंट कम अप एट ऑल एज कार्य दैट काइंड ऑफ सिचुएशन विल अराइज इफ यू से प्रकृति इज कूटस्था इट इज चेंजलेस देन द्वितीय पक्षे इफ यू से विकारिणी प्रकृति प्रकृति विल अंडरगो चेंजेस इट हैज चेंजेस देन द्वितीय स्वतः प्रच्युति उत अन्यतः सो स्वतः प्रच्युति और अन्यतः प्रच्युति नाउ दिस विकारास विच कम अबाउट एंड देर इज अ चेंज इन प्रकृति और प्रधाना इज दैट चेंज बाय इट्सेल्फ और इट इज क्रिएटेड बाय अनदर वेन एवर देर इज सम चेंज ईदर यू आई मीन कंसिडर समवन चेंजिंग ईदर समवन इज चेंजिंग बाय वनसेल्फ और बाय इन्फ्लुएंस फ्रॉम समवन एल्स यू विल टेक अ थिंग ऑल्सो अ थिंग इफ इट इज चेंजिंग बाय इट्सेल्फ देन वन पक्ष लाइक द मिल्क टर्निंग इन टू कर्ड सम एग्जाम्पल वी सॉ और घटा बींग क्रिएटेड ऑफ मृत समबडी इज मेकिंग इट अंडरगो चेंज सो देर आर पॉसिबिलिटीज ऑफ चेंज ईदर बाय वन सेल्फ और बाय समवन एल्स और समथिंग एल्स सो द्वितीय मीन्स इफ एट ऑल प्रकृति और प्रधाना इज विकारिणी देन हैज विकारास देन दोज विकारास आर गोइंग टू लीड टू प्रच्युति मीनिंग देर इज अ चेंज फॉल फ्रॉम द बैलेंस स्टेट देर इज इम्बैलेंस दैट इम्बैलेंस इट्सेल्फ इज विकार इट कैन लीड टू कार्य नाउ so that imbalance is it created by itself meaning prakriti or pradhana itself undergoes change or it is created by something or someone else na adhyah adhya paksha is what pradhana undergoes change on its own why not sada karya prasangat what will happen then if the pradhana is changing by itself then कार्य कैन बी क्रिएटेड वी एग्री यस प्रपंच कैन बी क्रिएटेड इफ प्रकृति इज चेंजिंग साम्यावस्था इज बिकमिंग असाम्य बाय इट्सेल्फ इफ इट इज बाय इट्सेल्फ देन वॉट इज दैट स्टॉप्स इट फ्रॉम चेंजिंग हाउ विल इट गो टू बैलेंस स्टेट अगेन दैट इम्बैलेंस विल कीप ऑन गोइंग मीन द चेंज विल बी कंटिन्यूअस इफ द चेंज इज कंटिन्यूअस देन प्रपंच विल बी क्रिएटेड कंटिन्यूअसली देर विल बी नथिंग कॉल्ड एज कल्पांता Pralaya, none of that is possible. So Pralaya will never be there. Sada Karya Prasangat means Jagat will be always existent. There will never be a Pralaya. Which is against the Shastra. Shastra says that the Srishti, Sthiti and Laya, all these are cyclical. Across Yugas, across Kalpas. So where will the where will there be sthiti, where will there be laya, there will only be srishti, srishti will be continuous, pradhana will continuously change and there will be continuous srishti, there will be never laya, pralaya. Na dvitiya, if you say no it is a second paksha, the change is created by other, then what will happen? Na dvitiya purushasya audasinya abhyupagamahanehe. This we have seen, this hetu was given earlier, if at all Pradhana is changing under the influence of someone else. The gunas are changing and going out of balance. ड्यू टू इन्फ्लुएंस ऑफ समवन एल्स, दैट समवन एल्स और समथिंग एल्स इज ओनली पुरुष, देर इज नथिंग एल्स अदर देन प्रधान. प्री क्रिएशन बिफोर द प्रपंच इज क्रिएटेड देर इज नथिंग अदर देन प्रधान एक्सेप्ट फॉर पुरुष. दैट पुरुष इज वॉट कैंड ऑफ अ पुरुष, पुरुष से औदासीन्य अभ्युपगम हाने ही इज उदासीन. पुरुष इज उदासीन, ही हैज नथिंग टू डू विथ एनीथिंग और एनी वन, ही इज डिस्कनेक्टेड अनअटैच्ड. दैट अनअटैचमेंट एंड न्यूट्रल परस्पेक्टिव ऑफ पुरुष विल गो फॉर अ टॉस विच इज क्लेम्ड बाई युअर सांख्य दर्शन. सो एक्सेप्टेड अभ्युपगम औदासीन्य इज एक्सेप्टेड बाय युअर ओन दर्शन. देर विल बी हानि ऑफ दैट, ड्यू टू दैट हानि यू कैनॉट टेक दैट पक्ष ऑल्सो, युअर दर्शन विल बी कॉम्प्रोमाइज. अतः देर फोर वॉट, देर फोर देर विल बी नो पॉसिबिलिटी ऑफ साम्य अवस्था चेंजिंग, देर इज नो पॉसिबिलिटी ऑफ बैलेंस बिकमिंग इम्बैलेंस ऑफ गुणास. गुणास विल ऑलवेज रिमेन इन अ बैलेंस स्टेट. देन वॉट विल हैपन, अतः प्रच्युत्य भावेन अंगांगी भाव अनुपपत्ते है. सिंस देर इज नो पॉसिबिलिटी ऑफ चेंज ड्यू टू अंगांगी भाव नॉट बीइंग देर, प्रधान कैनॉट क्रिएट कार्य, देन वॉट विल हैपन, कार्य अभाव प्रसंग इत्यर्थः. जगत कैनॉट बी क्रिएटेड, मीनिंग देर विल ऑलवेज बी दिस प्रलय हैज टेकन प्लेस और देर इज नो सृष्टि. बिफोर सृष्टि एज्यूम दैट देर इज प्रलय, दैट प्रलय इज नॉट सांख्य दर्शन प्रोसेस क्रिएटेड, इट इज नॉट क्रिएटेड बाय द प्रोसेस एज एक्सप्लेन्ड बाय सांख्य मत. और यू से दैट द क्रिएशन हैज नेवर टेकन प्लेस एज पर सांख्य मत, दे कैनॉट एस्टैब्लिश दैट सृष्टि विल एवर हैव टेकन प्लेस अर्लियर और विल टेक प्लेस. नेवर कैन सृष्टि टेक प्लेस बिकॉज देर विल नेवर बी एन इम्बैलेंस एज देर इज नो अंगांगी भाव एंड विदाउट द पार्ट्स देर कैनॉट बी चेंज whether created by oneself or by the other, and therefore pradhana can never become karana, pradhana is not karana. Gunanam anapeksha swabhavatvat na prachyutihi ityatra asiddhim ashankya pariharati. Now what the siddhanti is objected to, siddhanti has said what, gunanam anapeksha swabhavatvat न प्रच्युति ही, दिस द सिद्धांति सेइंग, सिद्धांति सेज दैट देर इज नो पॉसिबिलिटी ऑफ इम्बैलेंस ऑफ गुणास. व्हाई? बिकॉज ऑफ गुणास नॉट हैविंग डिपेंडेंसी, दैट इज वेरी स्वभाव ऑफ द गुणास, एज सत्व रजस तमस डू नॉट हैव एनी डिपेंडेंसी ऑन अदर्स, देर इज नो पार्ट होल रिलेशनशिप ऑल्सो, दे आर इंडिपेंडेंट, देर फोर प्रच्युति ही न. इत्यत्र असिद्धि आशंक्याः, देर असिद्धि, असिद्धि दोषा इज देर. ही सेज दैट दिस इज नॉट एस्टैब्लिश्ड, पूर्व पक्षी सेज देर इज नो एस्टैब्लिशमेंट ऑफ दिस एट ऑल, यू हैव जस्ट मेड अ स्टेटमेंट बट इट इज नॉट सो. सो दिस अनपेक्ष स्वभाव दैट इज असिद्ध, दिस अ हेतु, गुणानाम अनपेक्ष स्वभावत्वात् हेतु हो प्रच्युति ही न भवति, दिस इज दी क्लेम बाय दी सिद्धांति एंड दैट इज हाउ सिद्धांति हैज रिफ्यूटेड दी पूर्व पक्षी सांख्य. सो वॉट इज दी तर्का देर, उदाहरण कैनॉट बी थिंक थॉट अबाउट, बट देन गुणानाम, सो अनपेक्ष स्वभावत्व इज हेतु. सो यू हैव वॉट, यत्र यत्र धूमः तत्र तत्र वह्निः, बट फ्लिप साइड इज वॉट, अभाव पक्ष, इफ यू लुक एट अभाव साइड देन यू विल से यत्र यत्र वन्यभावः तत्र तत्र धूमाभावः. सो हियर वॉट हैज बीन सेड इज दैट अनपेक्ष स्वभाव, सो पॉजिटिवली ऑल्सो यू कैन से अनपेक्ष स्वभाव इज हेतु. सो यत्र यत्र अनपेक्ष स्वभाव तत्र तत्र गुणानां प्रच्युत्यभाव, और यत्र यत्र अपेक्ष स्वभावत्व अभाव तत्र तत्र गुणानां प्रच्युत्यभाव. दिस इज दी व्याप्ति दैट सिद्धांती इज यूजिंग, देयर दिस हेतु इज असिद्ध हेतु, दिस अनपेक्षा स्वभाव हेतु इज नॉट प्रूवन, सेज द पूर्व पक्षी. सो ही सेज व्हाट व्हाट इज दिस अनपेक्षा स्वभावत्व हेतु इज असिद्ध, इज असिद्ध हेतु. देयर बाय इफ दिस इज द डाउट असिद्धिम आशंक्य परिहरति. द सूत्रकार गिव्स अ परिहार टू दैट. ही सेज आई विल एक्सप्लेन. अन्यथा अनुमितौ च न्यशक्ति वियोगात्. अन्यथा अनुमितौ च न्यशक्ति वियोगात्. सो अन्यथा अनुमितौ च न्यशक्ति वियोगात्. सो सूत्र कैन बी अन्यथा एंड अनुमितौ कैन बी स्प्लिट. अदर देन दैट इट इज इन द स्प्लिट ऑर्डर इटसेल्फ. आई मीन इट इज इन दी देयर इज नो संधि विच्छेद टू बी डन. सो अन्यथा अनुमितौ मीनिंग वॉट? अनपेक्ष स्वभावत्वात् अन्यथा. इन अनदर वे इफ यू यूज अनुमिति विथ अनुमान प्रमाण यू लैंड ऑन सम ज्ञान. दैट ज्ञान इज कॉल्ड एज अनुमिति. सो अनुमिति ज्ञान इज थ्रू वॉट? दिस नॉट अनपेक्ष स्वभाव बट अपेक्षा स्वभाव. सो अपेक्षा इज देयर मीनिंग गुणास हैव अन्योन्य अपेक्षा. द गुणास हैव सत्व रजस तमस आर म्यूचुअली डिपेंडेंट ऑन ईच अदर. देन परस्पर अनपेक्षा वॉज सेड अर्लियर. नाउ परस्पर और अन्योन्य, परस्पर और अन्योन्य अपेक्षत्वेन. देर इज एन अपेक्षा. सो गुणानाम अन्यथा अनुमितौ अर्था च अन्यथा अनुमितौ च. एंड इफ यू इन्फर इट इन अनदर मैनर अदर देन व्हाट वी हैव सेड दैट अनपेक्ष स्वभाव गुणास डू नॉट हैव डिपेंडेंसी ऑन ईच अदर. सो यू मेक अ डिफरेंट क्लेम एंड देयर बाय अनुमति इज डिफरेंट. व्हाट इज दैट? गुणानाम अन्योन्य और परस्पर सापेक्षत्वेन. अपेक्षा इज देर. सो अपेक्षया सह वर्तते इति सापेक्ष तस्य भाव सापेक्षत्वम. देन सापेक्षत्वेन इंस्टेड ऑफ अनपेक्ष यू से स्वापेक्ष. गुणानाम सापेक्षत्व स्वभाव. वी नो नीड स्वभाव. यू कैन ऐड दैट ऑल्सो. गुणानाम सापेक्षत्व स्वभावत्वात् और गुणानाम सापेक्षत्वेन व्हाट विल लैंड ऑन? कूटस्थ अवस्था विच वॉज मेन्शनड अर्लियर. दिस कूटस्थ पक्ष विल गो अवे. वाई? बिकॉज गुणत्रय साम्यावस्था इज कॉल्ड एज प्रकृति एंड दैट वॉज सेड एज कूटस्थ. इट इज चेंजलेस और विकारिणी विथ चेंज. नाउ ही वॉन्ट्स टू से दैट देर विल बी चेंज बिकॉज पूर्व पक्षी इज सेइंग दैट प्रधान कैन हैव अ चेंज. ही हैज टू एस्टैब्लिश दैट. टू एस्टैब्लिश दैट ही कैनॉट से कूटस्थ पक्ष. सो ही इज सेइंग वॉट? दिस गुण साम्यावस्था इज गोइंग टू चेंज बाय गुणाज having dependency on each other. So there is an angangi bhava. So guna are not anapeksha swabhava. Gunas do not have anapeksha swabhavatvam. They have sapekshatvam. Anyonya sapekshatvam or paraspara sapekshatvam. That is the way the gunas can have change. Therefore akutastha. There is no kutastha kutastattvam. There be akutastattvam of pradhana. So akutastattvena meaning it is not a changeless entity. Kutastha is changeless entity. So akutastha means not a changeless entity. That is the anumana. Therefore anyatha anumitaucha means paraspara sapekshatvat akutastattvena cha anumitaucha. If that is your anumiti, then jnashakti viyogat pradhanam jagat karanam na bhavati, says the siddhanti. So anyatha anumitau cha is the option given by siddhanti to purva pakshi. If at all you say that my hetu, meaning अनपेक्ष स्वभावत्वम इज द हेतु प्रेजेंटेड बाय सिद्धांति एज एन ऑब्जेक्शन टू पूर्व पक्षीज प्रधान बींग जगत कारण प्रच्युति अभाव विल बी देर. therefore there will be no jagat karanatvam for brahma for pradhana. This is the objection raised by the siddhanti to purva pakshi sankhya. Hetu was given as anapeksha svabhavatvat. Anyatha anumitav means if at all this asiddha hetu, there is asiddhi in the hetu, is what the purva pakshi sankhya claims, then we will say okay, let's say the hetu is asiddha, then you say that I will give different hetu, opposite hetu, which is what apeksha sapekshatvam gunanam anyonya sapekshatvam, that is the hetu, and therefore with through that what will happen, since there is angangi bhava, there will be akutastha, means pradhana can undergo change. If that is your anumiti, then tesham gunanam nyashakti vyoga, do gunas have jnana shakti? They are not chetana. So same flaw will be there for gunas also. You take pradhana as jada achetana, or you take gunas and say gunas have dependency on each other. Even with the dependency on each other, gunas cannot change at all. Why? Jnashakti vyoga is there. Since there is no Nyashakti, and what have your own sutra, what has your own Karika said? Karika had said, earlier we had seen, Shakti taf pravrutteshcha. Shakti of the Karana makes the Karya through the pravrutti of the Karana. So Karana pravrutti into Karya, Karana changing into Karya is possible through the Shakti of the Karana. Where is the Shakti? Nyashakti is not there, Jnana Shakti is not there, because gunas are jada. Sattva Rajas Tamas gunas are jada. Therefore, Nyashakti Vyogat Pradhanam Jagat Karanam Na Bhavitum Arhati. Whichever paksha you take, if you say my Hetu is Asiddha, you use your own opposing Hetu. Even if it is Asiddha, I'll let you use it. But can you prove that Pradhana is Jagat Karana? In that case also Pradhana is not Jagat Karana. So your entire Sankhya Vada is Apramanika. That is where the Avirodha Adhyaya is progressing, especially the second Pada. Because here we have seen in the introduction as to, although we do not need to refute the Darshanikas, other Darshanas, still it is being done for the Advaita Vada to become Dridha. It should not be on shaky ground. Just because we understand Advaita, if there are one or two questions from someone who is confused or someone who is convinced of some other darshana, if he asks you one or two questions, you start questioning your own understanding. That should not be the case. Therefore, what is that nyaya called? Stambha Nikalna Nyasam Nyaya is there, whereby when you want to put up a tent or something, you will put a pole. You will put multiple poles. You will put a stump in the ground. So when you dig a hole and then you put at least one pole, then stones and other pieces of whatever wood or mud is used, clay or something, to fill the balance of the hole after putting in the sides of the hole. Around the pole circumference, you will start putting stone, pieces of stone, wood and mud, so that the pole is steady. Now how steady is it? Will it fall in the wind? Will it fall if the kids are playing around? Will it fall if something, if you are moving equipment and then that is hit, or per someone hits the pole, will it fall? The tent should not fall. Therefore, what will you do? You will start shaking the pole. You will shake the pole and then keep on filling the rest of the hole till the stump does not move, the pole does not move anymore. So that is what, after having placed the pole in the ground, still some filling has to be done, some testing has to be done, and then you revisit. So Shravana and Manana, all this is continuous. That is exemplified. So your understanding may be there. You say, okay, I have no doubts. Do you really have no doubts? That can be known only when other darshanas are studied. You need not study them for the academic interest or for other darshanas conclusion to be understood. What you are doing is that those explanations should not, or the doubts raised there or explanations given there should not end up confusing you as to your understanding, which was there earlier, being compromised. So all the study of other darshanas is to be done only so that your understanding of Advaita is dridha. Nothing should shake your understanding. That is the process. So that Nyaya is used, and here Avirodha, Avirodha Adhyaya, in this second pada, why are the others being refuted? Is because even if those darshanikas raise doubts against your darshanas, or they talk about their own darshana without attacking you, still you should not say that they are valid, my vision is invalidated. Neither should your understanding be invalidated, nor should you end up thinking that they are also right. There is nothing called as they are also right. You cannot have two ends. End is single. The means is going to be single. The end means is single. There can be many means for Chitta Shuddhi. There can be many means to sharpen your buddhi. There can be many means to have different goals as different kind of anitya muktis. So sarupa, sarupya, salukya, all these muktis are possible which are anitya. For that there may be different means. For siddhis there may be different means. But for nitya mukti there is only one means, that is advaita jnana. Jnanena moksha, that to advaita jnanena eva moksha. Jiva brahma aikya jnanena eva moksha. Moksha siddhi, that should be very clear. Therefore all this process is used as to, not only is the other darshanas objection towards advaita samanvaya being answered, objections being answered, but their own darshanas are completely disassembled. Why? Because every aspect, every perspective of the darshanikas is going to lead to advaita samanvaya compromise for a aparipakva jnana, meaning one who has aparipakva jnana. For that kind of a sadhaka, his jnana should be protected, and therefore everything else around, every other distraction or confusing aspect should be completely dissolved. It is completely disassembled. That is the perspective of the sutrakara when he is refuting the other darshanas wholesale. Meaning, now slowly moving towards the end of the Sankhya refutation, finally it will be said that there is no pramana, there is no pramanyam in Sankhya darshana. Therefore, even if they say that there is virodha with Advaita Samanvaya, we do not have any issues. They can keep on claiming, but apramana cannot have any virodha with pramana. Pramana Shastra, apramana Shastra cannot have, it is not Shastra, apramana darshana cannot have any virodha with pramana Shastra. That is where it is moving. So Nyashakti Vyogat, there is Gunanam Nyashakti Vyogat, Nyashakti He Vyogat. There is no Jnana Shakti in Gunas, they are Achetana, and therefore what? Pradhana cannot be Jagat Karana. Navayam Anapeksha Swabhavan Kutasthan Gunan Anumimi Mahe. See why this is called, why is it called as Anumiti? Because for gunas there is no pratyaksha pramana. Sattva guna is there, rajas is there, tamas is there, and they have come together and formed this pradhana which is jagat karana. For all that there is no pramana. Pratyaksha pramana is not there. In fact, Shruti also does not talk about it as jagat karana. Shruti may talk about sattva, rajas, tamas, gunas. Shastra may talk about it. And if Shruti is not there, we can infer the Shruti to be there because Smritis talk about it. We don't have an issue there, meaning we are not saying that there is nothing called as sattva, rajas, tamas, guna. We agree with sattva, rajas, tamas, because in Tattva Bodha or any other basic Vedanta Grantha also, the Srishti Prakriya is explained in this manner, how the Indriyas come up, how the Stula Sukshma, Mahabhutas come up. For all that, we'll say Sattva, Rajas, Tamas, Gunas are there. Independently, they do not become Jagat Karana. That's where the disagreement is. Now, what the Purapakshi is saying, your Hetu is Asiddhi. Hesu is Asiddha Hetu as to Gunanam Anapeksha Swabhavatvat. So, Na Vayam, says the Sankhya Purapakshi, Na Vayam Anapeksha Swabhavan Kutasthan Gunan Anumimi Mahe. So, that's an Anumana. Since there is no Pratyaksha Pramana, with some Pratyaksha in Karya, you assume something in Karana, and that Karana, you will say, Gunas are there. Sattva, Rajas, Tamas, and these gunas are Kutastha gunas. So Kutastha gunas, we are not inferring the Kutastha gunas by using the Hetu of Anapeksha Swabhava. Anapeksha Swabhava is not the Hetu which is leading to Kutastha gunas as per our darshana, says the Sankhya. So you are sadly mistaken when you use the Hetu as Anapeksha Swabhavatvad, Gunanam Anapeksha Swabhavatvad. We have never said that. So what we really say, Apitu, Anyatha Prakarantarana, in another way we say Anyatha, in another manner we do an inference. Anumiti, Anyatha Anumito is, Vayam, Anyatha Anumimi Mahe, we make an inference in another manner, not using your kind of a Hetu, which is Aropita on our Darshana. So anyatha prakarantarena gunan anyonya sapekshan anumimi mahe. So this anumimi mahe should be brought in. You should have an anuritti there. So we infer the gunas looking at the prapanchakarya or whatever as to what? They are anyonya sapeksha. They are mutually dependent on each other. Sattva, Rajas and Tamas. That those three gunas are inferred by us having dependency on each other. It is not that we are saying these gunas are independent. They do have dependency on each other. Evam anumitau satyam. When we have made such an anumiti, we don't have the doshas which are pointed by you, Siddhanti. Na pragukta dosha prasakti riti chet na. So we, this iti chet can be brought in from what is there in the 7th sutra. So iti chit pragukta dosha prasaktir nasti iti chit. Whatever doshas you have pointed out as to this kutastha will never change, all these options that you gave, vikarini, swatav prachyuti, uta anyatav prachyuti ityadi, all these doshas will not accrue, says the Purapakshi. There the Siddhanti says, yes, there is this pradhana being karana cannot be established, that dosha will still be there. Nyashakti viyogat, says the Siddhanti, gunanam jnana shakti rahitattva dityartha. Since the gunas do not have jnana shakti because they are jada achetana, therefore, what svatah prachitya bhavena, they cannot change by themselves. Some sentient entity should bring about changes in the form of imbalance, and then you can put together a different configuration and make Jagat as Karya using the same gunas. Then we will say that okay, Pradhana is Jagat Karana. But that is not possible because Nyashakti, Jnana Shakti is not there. Svatah Prachyutya Bhavena, therefore by itself, by themselves gunas cannot change. And therefore what? Same problem, Anga Angi Bhava Anupapatte. Anga Angi Bhava will not be possible. Therefore what? Karya Anudaya Prasanga. Taravasta, tadvadavasta eva, iti bhavaha. Therefore, you may say that pragukta dosha is not there, but pragukta dosha still continue to be there. All of them continue. Not only the end conclusion, which is what we are really interested in, saying that pradhana is not jagat karana, but being a nyaya prasthana, we have to explain as to why it cannot be. It cannot be because angangi bhava is not there. Angangi bhava is not there, then parts, part whole relation is not there. Parts cannot have a different configuration because earlier configuration of samya avastha cannot be having nasha. They cannot be separated out, and since they cannot be separated out and put together in a different order, यू कैनॉट हैव कार्य कार्य अनुदय प्रसंग तदवस्था तद्वद देर इज अ टाइप हियर तद्वद दिस तद्वद दिस तद वर्ड शुड हैव बीन अर्लियर सो देर इज अ टाइपो देर आई विल फिक्स इट लेटर आई विल मार्क इट एंड फिक्स इट लेटर और इट शुड बी तदवस्था इधर विषय तदवस्था और तद्वद अवस्था लेट मी चेक व्हाट इज दी एक्चुअल पाठ तदवस्था सो तदवस्था सो तद्वद इज नॉट तदवस्था सो तदवस्था एव सो दिस कार्य अनुदय प्रसंग तदवस्था एव तदवस्था मीन्स एज इट वॉज देर इट इज स्टिल कंटिन्यूइंग सा अवस्था यस्य सह तदवस्था सो दैट्स अ बहुरी समास टू मीन द सेम अवस्था दिस ऑल्सो हैज द सेम अवस्था एज अर्लियर सा अवस्था यस्य इज ऑफ दिस पर्टिक्युलर सिचुएशन दैट यू हैव गिवन द सॉल्यूशन दैट यू हैव गिवन दिस सॉल्यूशन ऑल्सो हैज दिस कार्य अनुदय प्रसंग सो कार्य अनुदय प्रसंग इज ए दोष सो दिस दोष इज सेम एज ए अर्लियर दोष सो वॉट वॉज यर्लियर दोष कार्य अनुदय प्रसंग सो सा अवस्था ऑफ दैट दोष सा दोष अवस्था सा प्राग दोष अवस्था यस्य यस्य इज दी एतत् स्थित हियर वॉट इज देयर दिस दिस एतद अवस्था सो सा अवस्था इज द प्राग अवस्था एंड द करंट अवस्था इज विद्यमान अवस्था इज यस्य सो सा अवस्था यू कैन से यस्य दैट कार्यानुदय प्रसंग यस्य कार्यानुदय प्रसंगस्य स कार्यानुदय प्रसंगः तदवस्थः एव सेम अव सेम काइंड ऑफ दोष इज देयर हियर एज वेल इति भावः नाउ फाइनली इतश्च असंगतम सांख्यमतम इति आह एंड फॉर दिस रीजन ऑल्सो सेज द सिद्धांति फॉर दिस रीजन एज वेल सांख्य मत इज असंगत इट इज नॉट अ राइट मत वाई विप्रतिषेधाचासमंजसम विप्रतिषेधाचासमंजसम सो विप्रतिषेधात् च असमंजसम प्रधाना बीइंग जगत कारण इज सांख्य मत दैट सांख्य सांख्य मतम असमंजसम इज नॉट राइट वाई विप्रतिषेधात् च एंड ऑल्सो ड्यू टू विप्रतिषेध व्हाट इज विप्रतिषेध परस्पर विरोध विप्रतिषेध इज ड्यू टू अपोजिशन वॉट अपोजिशन देर इज अ परस्पर विरोध इन सांख्य मत इट्स सांख्य मत इज नॉट अ सिंगल मत मीनिंग ऑल दो वी से सांख्य मत स्टिल इफ यू लुक एट सांख्य दर्शन ग्रंथाज देन दिस ग्रंथाज हैव डिफरेंट एक्सप्लेनेशंस विच आर कॉन्ट्राडिक्टरी अमॉन्ग देमसेल्व्स सो ईच सम ग्रंथाज टॉक अबाउट समथिंग सम अदर ग्रंथाज टॉक अबाउट समथिंग एल्स When you compare the Sankhya Mata in one Sankhya Grantha and Sankhya Mata in another Sankhya Grantha, there is Vipratisheda. There is Paraspara Virodha. Mutually, they are opposed to each other. Therefore, in your own darshana, you don't have unity. How will you establish Sankhya Mata as Samanjasa Mata, as a Sadhu Mata? It is Asadhu Mata. So, Vritti says, Sankhya hi kvachit. महतः पंचतन्मात्र सर्गम संगीरन्ते क्वचिद अहंकारात् अहंकारात् व्हाट सर्गम संगीरन्ते सो समवेयर सांख्यास टॉक अबाउट दी पंचतन्मात्र बीइंग क्रिएटेड फ्रॉम महत महत तत्व दे हैव दिस 24 प्रिंसिपल्स सो इन दैट दे टॉक अबाउट दी पंचतन्मात्रास दी सूक्ष्म इंद्रियास तन्मात्रास आर दीज महाभूतास विच हैव नॉट अंडरगॉन पंचीकरण सो दे आर वेरी सूक्ष्म सो दे आर कॉल्ड एज तन्मात्रास दीज तन्मात्रास हैव कम अप फ्रॉम व्हाट they explain their some explain that they have come up from Mahatattva. Mahatattva is the universal intelligent principle, which elsewhere, if you want to make similarities, draw similarities, then we will see that it is something equivalent to Hiranyagarbha. The antakarana of Hiranyagarbha, Hiranyagarbha also, there are, you know, divisions as to manas and buddhi at the universal level. But to get the point, something like that. So this Mahatattva is like that. So from that Mahatattva, Mahata is Panchami. Mahata Panchatanmatra Sargam Sangirante. From Mahat, some Sankhyas talk about creation of the Tanmatras. Kvachid Ahankarat. Elsewhere, the same Sankhyas talk about the Panchatanmatra, the five Tanmatras having Utpatti from what? From Ahankarat. Elsewhere, Kvachid Ekadasha Indriyani. In some Granthas, they talk about Ekadasha Indriyal. The sense organs are 11. So, five Jnanendriyas, five Karmendriyas and one Manas. So, that will make Ekadasha Indriyas. So, 11, they talk about 11 Indriyas. Some, at some places. Elsewhere, Kvachid Baihendriyani Twagindriye Antarbhavya Saptendriyani Iti. Sometimes, elsewhere, they talk about Twagindriye Antarbhavya. In the sense organ of touch, they include all the Baihya Indriyas. All the external organs, they include in what? Karmendriyas, they include in Twagindriya itself. So, Twagindriya plus 5 Jnanendriyas. Twagindriya will include all the other 5, other 4. So, Twagindriya is one. In that they include the others, sorry. Karmendriya is there. Twagindriya is Jnanendriya. So, in Jnanendriya, it will include the other 4. And then 5 sense organs plus this Twagindriya is separate 1, which includes the other 4. So, you will count it as 1. So, you got 6. And then Manas will be 7. So, Twagindriya Antarbhavya Saptendriyaniti. So, you have 7 Indriyas. So, sometimes you talk about Utpatti of Tanmatras from Mahat. Sometimes you talk about Utpatti of Tanmatras from Ahankara. Sometimes you talk about 11 Indriyas. Sometimes you talk about 7 Indriyas. So, you yourself are not sure as to how many and what has come from what. All this Anumiti imagination is all self-contradictory. They are all having mutual contradiction. Evancha paraspara vipratishedat, paraspara virodat ityartha, asamanjasam sankhyamatam. Sankhyamatam asamanjasam. Sankhyamata is not right because in your own granthas, in your own various explanations, there is internal contradiction. Tasmat sankhya siddhantaha bhranti moolaha evaiti siddham. So earlier in the opening what was said, the other darshanas will be analyzed and their virodhas, after refuting also, if they still say that there is virodha, as per their grantha, we will say that that virodha is irrelevant to us or anyone. It should be irrelevant to you also who is a mukshu. Why? Because it is not a pramana. So if we can prove that it is not pramana moola darshana siddhanta, it is what? Bhranti moolaha, it is all imagination without any basis and it is refuted by self-contradiction, showing self-contradiction or showing tarka, then this siddhanta of these darshanikas is no siddhanta at all. Why? Because it is not pramana moola siddhanta, it is bhranti moola siddhanta. So we have proved that it is based on some deluded thinking, it is not rightful thinking, therefore even if there is virodha perceived, that virodha is having no strength at all. It is all imagined virodha. With what? With samanvaya, with advaita tattva. Iti siddham. Thereby sankhya mata stands refuted. Sankhya darshana itself, whose siddhanta is what? Pradhana is jagat karana. And you have to know this pradhana, you have to know the purusha, you have to know all these prakritis, prakriti vikrutis and vikrutis, then you should separate out this purusha from cognitively from this pradhana and all the mahat and indriyas and panchamahabhutas tanmatras ityadi. All that is to be set aside completely because pradhana being jagat karana will not lead you to moksha. This is the reason sankhya darshana is not acceptable at all. Now the tarkika paksha is taken. What about their darshanas, vaisheshika, nyaya vaisheshika? So vaisheshika darshana is taken as tarkika darshana because nyaya vaisheshika is similar. So purvam, and thereby the next adhikarana comes up. This is not sankhya darshana, it is all tarkika darshanas. Purvam prapanchasya pradhana nishtha shabdatvadi gunananvayat pradhana anupadanakatvavat brahma guna chetanatva ananvayat brahma upadanakatvam nasyad iti drishtanta sangatya idamah. So now drishtanta sangati is there. This adhikarana is coming up with a drishtanta sangati. An example is given by the Purvapakshi as to what? We will use the same process that you have used, and we'll give another example having a similar process. You should agree that pradhana, the way pradhana is not jagat karana, brahma is also not jagat karana. Why? So purvam prapanchasya pradhana nishtha shabdatvadi guna ananvayat. Pradhana nishtha, in pradhana what gunas are not there? In pradhana, in prapancha, prapanchasya guna ananvayat, prapancha does not have pradhana nishta shabdatvadi gunas. This shabdat nishta shabdatva, so nishta shabdatva is nishta ashabdatva. So pradhana nishta ashabdatvadi guna ananvayat. So I'll read that again. In the shabdadi, in a samasa, the pada should not be broken, but then for clarity it has to be broken. So pradhana nishta shabdatvadi gunananvayat is what? Pradhana nishta ashabdatva adi, adi padena ashabdatva asparshatva ityadi. All of these gunas which are there in pradhana, not the sattva rajas tamas, but other gunas also, these gunas which are explained as pradhana is ashabda, pradhana does not have shabda, asparsha. So all that we talk about brahma also, as the Shruti talks about, they are saying that this is what is pradhana all about. Pradhana has these gunas, meaning pradhana is ashabda, asparsha, achakshu, ashrotra ityadi. All these are what? Pradhana nishta gunas. That is pradhana, therefore pradhana nishta gunas are ashabdatvam, asparshatvam ityadi. And are these seen in prapancha? Prapancha has shabda, so shabdatva is there in prapancha. Prapancha karya, you can touch ghatadi prapancha, ghatapatadi prapancha. If you tap the ghata, ghata will have shabda, will make shabda. Therefore in prapancha shabda is there, shabdatva is there. If you touch the pot ghata, you will have sparsha also, so sparshatva is also there. Therefore asparshatva is not there. So what is the argument made is that all these gunas that you were objecting to earlier as being in pradhana, and they do not extend to prapancha, therefore pradhana is not jagat karana, because prapancha has gunas which are not having pradhana anvaya, pradhana guna anvaya. So pradhana gunanam anvayaha prapanche nasti, prapancha guneshu na drishyate. You don't see pradhana gunas, or na drishyante in plural. None of these pradhana gunas are seen in the prapancha. Therefore prapancha cannot be the karya of pradhana. This is the sum total of the argument, or this is the perspective that the Purvapakshi Tarkika is taking from the refutation of Sankhyas by the Advaitin Siddhantin. So purvam, earlier, prapanchasya pradhana nishta ashabdatvadi guna ananvayat. Since prapancha does not have these gunas, therefore what did you say? Pradhana anupadanakatvavat. Pradhana was said to be, was not accepted as upadana. So anupadana, pradhana is anupadana karana, is not a upadana karana for prapancha. Similarly, vat, tadvat, Similarly, I'll give you another example. That is the drishtanta sangati. What is the drishtanta given? Brahma guna chetanatva ananvayat prapanchasya. Prapanchasya brahma guna chetanatva anvaya astiva nava. Nasti, says the tarkika himself. He raises a question. Is there this chetanatva? Adi also you can add. Chetanatva is the... So chetanatva is taken because astitva and something else can be shown. But let's take only one guna. You can add adipada also, but I am saying chetanatva, chetana, brahma is chetana. Prapancha is achetana definitely. So brahma, chetana is guna. Chaitanya guna in brahma, chetanatva is chaitanya. Chaitanya or chetanatva in brahma is not seen in the prapancha. Prapancha is jada achetana, whereas brahma is chetana. So brahma guna chetanatva. Brahmani chetanatva is the guna. So brahmani or brahmana guna. Brahma guna is brahmana guna, brahma guna. Brahmana guna is what? Brahma gunascha chetanatvancha. Brahma gunascha tat chetanatvancha brahma guna chetanatvam. That guna is not seen in prapancha. Prapanchasya nasti. In prapancha does not have chetanatva, therefore it does not have brahma guna, which is chetanatva. Therefore there is no anvaya in prapancha. So brahma guna chetanatva ananvayat, since there is no continuation of this chetana into karya, which you claim to be brahma karya, this prapancha, you cannot claim so. Why? Because anvaya is not seen, chetanatva is not seen in karya. If at all brahma were to be the karana of prapancha, then brahma guna, which is chetana, would have been seen in the prapancha also. But prapancha is achetana, therefore what? Brahma upadanatvakam, brahma upadanakatvam nasyad. Similar logic you have to use, what you have used to refute the purvapakshi sankhya. We the tarkikas will extend that to your siddhanta vedanta also, as to brahma is not upadana karana, because chetana guna in brahma is not seen in prapancha, which you claim to be brahma karya. Iti drishtanta sangatya idamaha. What is the adhikarana? Mahat dirgha adhyadhikaranam. So mahat dirgha adhikarana. See, mahat is one guna, mahat. Quite large, anu mahat, you see in tarka sangra. So mahat is parimana, mahat parimana, size. You look at the size. If you say ghata, what size is ghata? Ghata has mahat. Compared to what? You have to always compare bigger than what, smaller than what. So anu parimana and mahat parimana is all subjective. So it can be huge or a little big compared to what? So something else. So whatever is the comparison there. So when you say paramanu, anu is what? Smaller, small, smaller in size. But when you say paramanu, means there is nothing smaller than that. That is paramanu. Paramanu is atom. So from these atoms, dvyanuka has come up. So from paramanu, dvyanuka has come up. Then from dvyanuka, trenukas have come up. So this is the siddhanta of the tarkikas, nyaya vaisheshikas. So when you say dvyanuka is mahat compared to dvyanuka is not said to be mahat really, but trenuka is said to be mahat. And what is that? When you combine the two atoms, paramanus, you get dvyanuka. When you combine three dvyanukas, you will get trenukas, and trenuka onwards can be seen, meaning it is visible to naked eye. Paramanus and dvyanukas are not visible to the naked eye. This is what is the claim made by the claim, in a sense it is all kalpita or anumita by tarkikas. So now that is being looked at. As to mahat and dirgha, dirgha is long, hraswa is small or shorter. So short and long. Then So Anu and Mahat, Hraswa and Dirgha, these are all terminologies for measure, whether it is measured by weight or length or size. So there are all measuring units. Now you use these and you have a comparison and categorization, says the Siddhanti to the Purvapakshi. So that is the Adhikarana. Now with that objection which was given by the Purvapakshi, Tarkika, as to Brahma cannot be Upadana Karana, because Brahma Gunas are not extending to the Karya Prapancha, to the Prapancha, therefore Prapancha is not Karya of Brahma. We'll show as to why it is possible and how your own darshana is compromised if you apply the same thumb rule to your own darshana. That is the Mahadirghati Adhikaranam. Mahadirghavadva Hraswa Parimandalabhyam. Mahadirghavadva Hraswa Parimandalabhyam. So the Sutrakara says Mahadirghavat, like Mahat and Dirgha, which are your own guna categorizations. So he says this Mahat Dirgha Vat Va, or like, so Va is cha arthe, we'll see. Va has a meaning of cha also, but the padachheda is Mahat Dirgha Vat Va Hraswa Parimandalabhyam. Hraswa Parimandalabhyam is obviously a dvivachana. So what is being said is that this Vaisheshika view, where your Mahat Dirgha, Mahat and Dirgha Vat, like your Mahat and Dirgha, we'll see what this means. Meaning the Karana Gunas extending to Karya is not always the case. So Chaitanya Guna, Chetanatva is a Guna in Brahma, which is Karana, has to extend in the Karya Prapancha, is not a Niyama. Why? Because it is not seen in your own darshanas. In your darshana you are using, and you are the people who are categorizing based on analysis of Parimana Ityadi. Or the categorization is also based on the Guna. So you see similarities, you categorize them together. So you are an expert in that, and whatever process you are using, that has this flaw which you are raising in our Siddhanta. So aren't you ashamed? Ask the Siddhanti to the Purvapakshi, how can you even bring up this question? As Guna of the Karana is not seen in the Karya, therefore your Karya Karana Bhava is not working out. We'll make the same objections. Your entire, for us it is all Kalpita. We'll say that for us, if you raise an objection also, we have no issues. Shruti has given that Tatparya. But in your case, your entire Darshana is based on this categorization. You are Vaisheshikas. You are looking at Visheshas particularity to categorize. How can you even bring this up when you have a similar issue there? So this Mahat, how this Mahat Guna comes up from non-Mahat, how this Dirgha comes from non-Dirgha, that you have to explain first. So if you look at this, Hraswa Parimandalabhyam is Tritiya Dvivachana or Panchami Dvivachana, Panchami Dvivachana. So from the Hraswa and Parimandala, so Parimandala is Paramanu. From the Hraswa Parimana and Paramanu size, Mahat comes up and Dirgha comes up. So when you put together two Paramanus, what you get is what? You get Dvanuka. From three Dvanukas, you get Trenuka. So now you tell me, Trenuka is Dirgha and Mahat, whereas Paramanus and Dvanukas are what? Hraswa and Paramanu size. They are Paramanu size, they are not Mahat size. They are Hraswa, they are not Dirgha. So how can you get Mahat and Dirgha from Hraswa and Parimandala means Paramanu. Paramanu, how many Paramanus you put together, you cannot. Paramanu is a particular size, Parimandala is a size. So that atomic size cannot lead to non-atomic Dirgha size. Why? Because you are yourself saying that the Karana Guna should pervade into the Karya. It is not pervading in your case. It is exactly opposite. just like chetana is not pervading, you get achetana in the siddhanta vedanta. You cannot object to it. Why? Because your trenuka is visible to the naked eye, whereas januka and paramanus are not visible to naked eye. They are, paramanus are hraswa, paramanu size. They are hraswa, they are short. But your trenuka suddenly happened to be mahat and dirgha. So aren't you ashamed to even bring this up while your entire basis, entire actually foundation itself, when paramanus come together, they become dvyanuka, and dvyanukas come together, they become trenukas. That itself is a basic building block. There itself you have this flaw. So you can throw away your entire darshana, then object to our Brahma not being karana for prapancha. This is the sutra artha. We'll see details in the vritti in the next part. I have given the background of what it is. We'll see more in the next part in the vritti. आम्नायन्ते संसिद्धम् आदि मध्यांत वर्जितम् आनंद घनम् अपूर्णम् आत्मज्योति रूपास्महे. नमस्ते. धन्यवाद.
धन्यवाद.
नमस्ते.